Okay, so the next stop on our story is Margie. Margie's worried. And Margie's worried because her sister is losing it. So now her sister's on her trip out of town to Minnesota to the Mall of America. And she's in her own little loony land, and Margie is worried. Margie is worried because she has discovered, as she has been sifting through all of this hoarded stuff in the barn that is Stanley Peters Sr.'s life, Stanley Peters's dead body under all of the mire that is his tools and stuff like that out in the barn. So she and Stan Jr. have been sifting through this stuff, and Elliot, of course, is oblivious to all this, and the sheriff suspects that there is foul play, of course, and she's trying to sort of shield Ellie from all of this, because Ellie's sort of losing her mind, number one, because she's been abused all these years, and number two, because she's elderly and suffering from dementia. So Margie's trying to protect her from this, and Margie is lonely. She's been talking about sex on the phone for the last 6 months. Parental advisory, by the way, for any of you who might have small children around. She's been talking about sex for the last 6 months, and she's been without her husband, so she's very lonely. She is on her way to Bismarck, and she's wearing her best dress. She is about to pick up the Bismarck Coroner at the Peacock Alley Bar and Grill Hotel for a one-night stand, and she is going to drill him for information about her brother-in-law's case to see if she can find out about what's going on with Stanley Peters' death, and see if she can find out information. And maybe if she gets laid in the process, she'll be a happy camper. So she's getting ready for her date. She's going to pick this guy up at the bar. This is one of my favorite scenes in the whole book. Chapter 15, where Margie picks Jim McDaniel up at Peacock Alley. Chapter 15, their banter is just fun stuff. If you guys are into this stuff in the audiobook, chapter 15 is great fun. Best dress.